I bring you greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, beloved of God. This is Pastor Dennis here once again on Just a Word. I am here for one purpose, and just to bless your week, even as we have stepped into another week. I believe that the Lord is going to fulfill the desires of your heart as you make time to listen to this word. If today happens to be your first time of watching me, I would kindly plead with you to subscribe. Just click on the notification button and be notified, because every week there is something for us to ponder upon. Now, in the word of the Lord today, I want us to have a look at what's happened in the book of Mark chapter 4. There is an account of Jesus traveling in a boat with his disciples. And the Bible says that he said to them, "Let us go over to the other side." It's quite interesting that in our journey with the Lord, there are so many things which happen that tend to make us wonder if indeed we actually had to go this length, or we even had to embark on the journey after all, or we even had to start in the first place. There are things that people do go through, and that makes them ask themselves a whole lot of questions, whether it's even worth it being children of God, or worth it being a child of God, or being a Christian. But I want you to understand, no matter what happens, we are still in the hands of the Lord. Now, as they journeyed, the Bible says that suddenly there arose the tempest. There was some storm that came against them. The reason why storms do come against us, it's not just for our sake. It is because of the journey that we are embarking. It is because of who has you, or it is because of the man that you are working with. It's because of your assignment. It is because of the destiny that you are carrying. The storms came upon the waters, and as a matter of fact, it is not so strange to travel on the sea and to encounter a storm. But the Bible says that this was so sudden that the waves almost had covered the boat. It looked as if that there was no way, and the only thing that was going to happen was that they were going to die. They were so afraid for their lives, because that was not planned for. One of the things that I have realized in most insurance policies, there is what we call the fine print. So we tell you about everything except for the things that are in the fine print. So in our walk with the Lord, there are certain things that are not also mentioned. He does not give us a full glimpse of what is going to happen to us and how the journey is going to go. The reason why God does not give us the details of our journey is because if he is to tell you exactly everything that is going to happen in the course of your journey, you would be filled so much with fear, you wouldn't want to even go. You wouldn't even want to be promoted. If he told you of the attack that you would be getting as a result of the new job, or as a result of the position that he's elevating you, you would want to dwell, or you'd want to stay at where you are. But once he has secured your place of upliftment, once he has opened an opportunity for you, I want you to understand, no matter the storms that shall rise against you, the Lord shall ensure that you will be saved. Your safety is assured. So the tempest arose, the storm rose. It was so violent that the disciples began to cry, because they were not expecting the journey with Jesus to go in such a manner. If not for anything at all, it wouldn't have been so strange if they were traveling on their own accord. It wouldn't have been so strange if they had just decided to go on a casual trip. But the Lord Jesus said that, "Guys, let us go over to the other side." As they journeyed, the storms came against them. Sometimes what disturbs us so much is you do not understand why you have got to struggle the way you're struggling. You do not understand why you have got to deal with certain things the way you are dealing. I thought I was a child of God. I thought that I've been born again. I thought I'm spirit-filled. I thought that God is with me every step of the way. I thought he said that he would neither leave me nor forsake me. Why have I got to go through this? Why have I got to deal with this pain? Why have I got to go through a time of endless disappointments?
If it was on my own accord, I wouldn't have been disappointed. I wouldn't have been disturbed. But I can't believe that I have Jesus with me. Jesus is in the boat with me. And the storm is still rising. Yes, the storm is still going to come at you. But there is an assurance. So far as Jesus is in your boat, you would never lose your life. So far as you have Jesus in your boat, come what may, all that would happen is your safety. And so Bible says that the storm, they began to be tossed from every side, from one side onto the other. And to their amazement, the one who told them to join them was even sleeping. Jesus was sleeping. He could not be bothered by the storms that was against them. He was sleeping. The reason why he was sleeping is he was focused at where he was going. He was so much aware that nothing was going to stop the journey. He knew that he was going to get to his destination. And so whatever is happening in the course of the journey has nothing to do with his destination. Beloved, I want you to understand that sometimes we get all so afraid and we fear for our lives. We do not know how our children are going to turn up. We do not know how the society is going to make of us. We do not know how the economy is going to make of us. But one thing I want you to understand, that whatever you are dealing with is just in the course of your journey. Your destination is assured. You will definitely get to the place where you have to get to. That is why Jesus wasn't bothered, because he knew that he was going to the other side. And so if the storm has arose, the storm has nothing on him, and it has nothing to do with his destination. So he was just sleeping. And the Bible says that the disciples had to wake him up, that, "Master, carest thou not that we perish? Did you bring us this far that we would die?" And you know why they were so alarmed? Because even though they had Jesus with them, even though they had the man who has all authority with him, they had Jesus with them in the boat. They could have even touched him if they wanted to. Jesus was so closer to them, but their focus was on what they were seeing. Their focus was on the storm and not on the authority that they had with them. Their focus was just upon the thing that was going on around. Beloved, I came to encourage you. If you would look away from the Lord Jesus and be focused at the storm that you are seeing, and be focused at all the negative news that is around, and be focused at all the disappointments and the hurt and the pain, I am telling you, you will be alarmed. But if you will look away from the storm, if you look away from your hurt, if you look away from your disappointment and look to Jesus, the one who is with you, the Bible says that he is closer than a brother. That is what Jesus is up to us. That is how Jesus is with us. He is right there within you in the midst of your storm. He is right there with you in the midst of your pain. He is right there with you. If you shall call upon him, if you shall look away from the storm and look to Jesus, I tell you, you will not be alarmed as the disciples were alarmed. And when they called out unto Jesus, the Bible says that he spoke, and the storms died down. I want you to be encouraged that in this coming week, whatever storm which is risen against you, whatever storm that is purported against you, whatever plan which has been plotted against you, I pray in the name of Jesus, and that it will die down in the name of Jesus. Peace be still. And I pray that your week will be more than a blessed one in the name of Jesus. Look away from all the troubles outside and look within you, because that is where Jesus, your Savior, resides. He's just right inside of you. May the Lord richly bless you as you have made time to listen to me on Just the Word. God richly bless you. Bye-bye.